So before I stitch my placement crosshair, I'm going to thread the machine up with a darker thread color just so you can see what this looks like. Be aware you can use whatever works for you that you can see. If you want to use your first color of thread, that's fine. But I'm just doing it in this dark color so that you can see what's going on. I'm gonna attach my hoop to the machine. And I'm going to stitch that crosshair right on the stabilizer. Our next step is going to be to take our towel that we prepared earlier with pressing and folding onto that crosshair, as well as loading up the main part of the design. You want to make sure you delete the crosshair off the screen before you load up the piece of cake design. Make sure that you have it set into the same hoop size that you're using, and that the design is centered in the hoop. Once you have all of those there, we can place our towel on the crosshair, and I'm gonna take the hoop off of the machine so that I can show you how to place this easily on your crosshair. I have my towel folded in half lengthwise, as well as up 4 inches like it's told me in the instructions. And I'm just gonna lay those folds on the line, open it up, make sure that I'm on that line. And then I'm gonna open this up. I'm gonna make sure this lines up with this line. I can kind of feel that stitch through my towel. And then I'm gonna stick it down in place and take this back to the machine where I'm going to hoop it. And I want to make sure that you pull all of the excess towel out and under. So I'm going to make sure all my excess towel is flipped back. If you want to pull yours up and clip it so that it stays out of the way, that's an option definitely for you as well. But I'm just gonna make sure everything's smoothed out and out of the way. And from here, even though we're using a sticky stabilizer to place that, get it in place nice and evenly, I'm gonna go ahead and do a basting stitch because most of the machines have a built-in basting function. So I'm gonna turn the baste around the hoop, or around the embroidery design function on, simply because I like to use this to make sure nothing's gonna shift and go where it shouldn't, as well as I kind of like to also use it to check to make sure that I kept things nice and straight, that things look even, and that everything looks pretty. Because once I start that design, I don't want to rip it out. So if I stitch the basting and the basting is not in the right position, it's easy to tear out and I can reposition my towel on a sticky. So I'm going to put my first color of thread in, which is going to be white, and I'm going to use the white because it's going to do the placement stitch for my plate. And since we're using white leather, I'm going to want to tack that down with white because it is going to be a raw edge applique. Now that my placement stitch is there, I'm going to take my piece of white leather and I'm going to put the leather side facing up, and I'm going to make sure I cover that entire area. If you want to here, you can tape this down with some Kimberbell tape. If you're comfortable and you've done a lot of applique before, you can just kind of smooth it as it goes. Just make sure you don't put too much pressure that the machine and the hoop can't move freely. From here, we're going to trim around the outside line of the leather. You have a couple options. One, you can set your machine to move to trim position, and that's going to shoot the hoop out towards you. And you can trim it right here. Or if you're more comfortable taking the hoop off the embroidery arm and trimming because you're going all the way around, you can definitely do that as well. I personally like to remove the hoop so that I can turn it around as I trim. Once I have everything trimmed, I'm going to put the towel back on, making sure that I do not get my towel caught underneath of the hoop. We do not want to stitch the back of our towel to the front of our towel. That's never good. From here, it's going to do a placement stitch for our bottom layer of cake. If you did move your hoop to the trim position, you have a couple options. One, you can go back to your hoop position and move it to the current position. Or if you're ready to start stitching, if you've already loaded your thread with the next color, you can just hit go or start or play, whatever your button says, and it will take the machine right back to where it left off. So you don't have to do that extra step if you're ready to go. So I'm just going to hit the start button and we're going to do a placement stitch for the bottom layer of the cake. I'm going to cover up the area of the rectangle that was the placement line. Again, you can tape this in place or you can just go ahead and stitch it. And here, I'm just going to trim around that outside edge. And then we're just going to hit go and it's going to do the placement stitch for the next layer of cake. Once it's done the decorative stitch around the two sides, the front and the bottom side of this piece of cake, then we're going to move on to the placement stitch for the next piece, layer of cake. And for this particular one, I chose to use the same color. Our placement stitch for layer two has now been stitched, so I'm going to take the second layer of fabric and just cover up that area and tack it down. Again, from here, I'm just going to move my fabric to trim position. I'm going to trim right along that edge. I like these little Kimberbell duckbill scissors. They're nice to get close up to those edges, especially on some of these pieces that are going to have a decorative stitch along the edge. From here, I'm just going to hit my start button. It's going to go back and it's going to stitch that same decorative edge stitch right here across the front of this piece. Now, before I place this fourth layer of cake, I want to stop and tell you something I didn't really tell you on these other three. Before I started, I prepped my layers of cake fabric. You have two options. One, because this towel is bright pink and we're stitching kind of lighter colors over top of it for appliques, I would recommend putting either a woven fusible or an SF-101 product on the back side of your fabric so that it doesn't show through, especially the lighter colors, the white and the cream, even the pink. Just to keep the color of that bright pink towel bleeding through. The other option, which is what I chose to do instead of woven fusible or SF-101, was I used soft fuse, which is a double-sided fusible webbing. It's used a lot for applique, and it's a paper product. Soft fuse is a very thin version of it, which is really nice. And you just iron it to the back of the surface of your fabric. It will help a little bit with the bleed through. So you may even want to do both. You may want to add the woven fusible and the fusible backed web. They do two different things. They both will help stabilize the fabric a little, but the one will just be an extra layer to keep the bleed through from coming through. Whereas the fusible webbing actually will make your fabric have a glue side on it that will stick to the fabric. And then when we peel the paper away and put it down, we're going to stitch this in place, okay, just like we did with all the layers. And I actually had this webbing on all of my layers. This white one you might want to do the woven fusible and the fusible web if you decide to go that route. But what the fusible web will allow for is I will be able to take my iron and put it on top of this fabric, and it will adhere the fabric to the towel to keep it from shifting or moving around. So if this is going to get used a lot and washed a lot, and I just don't want that fabric to pull away from there at some point, this is a nice way to do that. And really, realistically, what I would do is after I trim each layer when I've used the soft fuse, and you can do this for any embroidered applique. This is used for standard just applique that you're doing. It keeps things in place for you. You're going to trim that away. And once you've trimmed it away, you're going to take this to your ironing surface. And I can take my hoop, lay it right on top of my wool mat. I have my tiny steam fast iron, and I'm just going to lay this over top of that. It will activate the glue and adhere those pieces of fabric down onto the towel and kind of attach them there, not by just the stitching, but by the glue as well. What you want to keep in mind is this leather that they use, you can iron it. It's not a problem. I like to use a pressing cloth, so I just kind of try to keep the iron directly off of it. So I don't want to take my iron and just sit it down here for a long period of time to get my glue activated. But I can do all four layers at once. Since it's not doing a lot of stitching around, you're not going to see a lot of shifting first. But if you want to hit this with the iron between each layer, by all means, you can do that. Depending on what the applique stitching that I do looks like. Sometimes I pull it out between every applique and do that pressing first. So then once I have that ironed down and in place, that's going to give you just a really nice clean finish. It's going to keep things from bubbling up or puckering. I know that that sometimes is an issue for people. They don't like the way that looks if something starts to shift a little. This is just going to make it look more professional. So I'm going to put my hoop back on the embroidery arm. I'm going to make sure that towel is not wrapped around at all behind it. And now we're going to stitch that decorative stitch right along this last edge. Once it's finished with that, we're going to go ahead, we're going to change the thread color. And then I'm just going to stitch the decorative stitch around the cake plate. Now we're going to change our thread color to a silver or gray. I'm using cloud to do the stitching for the fork. And from here, we're going to move on to the thread color that shall be your frosting color between the layers as well as on the top and back side of the cake. So I'm going back to that new gold color. It's just kind of a creamy beige. That's what I chose for this one. So now that it's all finished stitching the frosting on your cake, you're gonna unthread and rethread. I'm gonna use red. Scarlet is the color I'm using for my cherry. It's gonna do the placement stitch first, and then we'll tack down the red leather for our cherry. These leathers are so much fun for appliques, for backgrounds, for all kinds of stuff. They sew through beautifully, and they're very smooth and give stuff a really nice texture. So if you haven't tried them, they come in a lot of different colors now. Navy and teal, pink, black, white, red, silver, gold, all kinds of good stuff. So you're just going to take your square of leather and cover up the cherry area. Again, you can tape this in place. You can hold it in place. I'm going to remove the hoop so that I can trim this because it is tiny and tight around. I'm going to change thread colors to do my stem. And then from here, I'm going to change thread again. Told you it was a short, quick color. The cherry would be fun to do in the red glitter vinyl too. That one stitched quick too. And then we're going to move on to the lettering that is on the cake. Life is short, eat the cake. How cute is that? Now, this is a tiny straight line little font. So a couple things that I always like to tell people. Tend to, when I'm doing a tiny small font like this, to use a smaller needle, maybe a 60 or a 70. The reason being is that the thickness of the needle will actually distort the tiny little stitches a little bit if you use a larger needle. If you don't have a smaller needle, don't want to change out your needle, another trick you could do is to match your bobbin thread to your top thread, just to make sure that you don't get any of that pick through, and you get a nice, clean, pretty letter. So it's totally up to you what you want to do. I just like to always give people the options. Tiny little fonts sometimes have a tendency to do different things, so I always like for people to have options to make it look the prettiest. So I'm just gonna switch out my bobbin real quick because I have one of those right here. I don't have a small needle right next to me. Right now I'm just using an embroidery. It looks like it's a 90, so that's why I wanna change my bobbin thread. If it were a 75, I probably would have left it. This is a pretty big needle for this tiny little font. I'm using black for my lettering, so I slipped in a black bobbin, thread the top of the machine with black thread, and we're gonna let it stitch. And from here, our embroidery is finished. Now that we have the design completely stitched, before I take it out of the hoop, I like to flip it over, take my seam ripper, and just pop about every third or fourth one of those basting stitches. And I always like to pop away from the embroidery design as I go around, just so I don't accidentally hook one of these pretty stitches in the design. And also, this is where I would take my scissors. I like to do it while it's in the hoop and trim up any of those jump stitches or extra stitches, things on the back that you don't really want hanging off of this pretty little towel. And then I just kind of pull away a little bit till I can get a hold of that stitch. And because I've popped all those stitches, it's just gonna pull right out. And if you have one of these wonderful seam fix seam rippers, this will just, this little rubber end, if you haven't used one of these, the little rubber end on here is made to just pull those threads out. Once I have that all cleaned out how I like it, again, I kind of will just pull the towel away from the sticky. And I like to use my seam ripper to do this. I just will take it, stick my seam ripper into the stabilizer, and cut closely around the embroidery so that when I get this all the way finished and trimmed out of here, I can take this and rinse it. Now, one thing that's super important about these dyed towels, especially, is the color on them. Because of how they're made, and it tells you on the package, but I like to reiterate this, it's really important to, it says soak them in cold water. I would pre-wash them. I would throw a color catcher in there with them. I would not stick them in with other colors, to keep things from bleeding, because that is a possibility. So definitely a shout color catcher, pre-soak the towel at least, rinse it. If not, go ahead and wash it to get all of that excess dye out of there. Definitely something that's really important, because when you go to wash this, you don't want that pink fading all over your pretty piece of cake.